Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're filming a lot of videos, so I am talking a lot about Salesforce today. Today we're gonna be talking about why should you use Salesforce as a company, or why would someone want to use Salesforce as a company? I've gotten a lot of comments recently saying like, why would anyone ever want to use Salesforce? It really depends on the company and how people are using it and if you're actually training your users. Let's go ahead and jump into the video and we can talk about it. So Salesforce essentially is a cleaner version of a spreadsheet like Google Sheets or Excel. Keeps all of your customer information in one simple database that is in your browser like Chrome or Firefox. And there are a bunch of different things that you can do within Salesforce that you can't necessarily do in a spreadsheet, but it is a very clean version of a spreadsheet. So Salesforce is approximately $150 per month per user. Now that sounds like a lot of money, especially if you are a larger company, or even if you're a smaller company and things are still pretty tight, it's not a small price to pay. So when considering if your company wants to move to Salesforce or use Salesforce, you're really going to want to understand what your ROI is going to be for it and if this is going to help your company to grow and sell more. Salesforce is a great way to keep all of your data in one place. So there are three different things called objects within Salesforce. This is the groups of data, things like the different deals that you have in the pipeline. This is going to be your forecasting. This is going to keep track of any of your tickets or your service tickets that are coming into Salesforce, your prospects or leads as they're called within Salesforce, as well as the accounts and the contacts, as well as a bunch of different stuff within Salesforce. And because all of this data already is within Salesforce, you're able to report on it within Salesforce and visualize it within Salesforce. Also, another reason is Salesforce, visually, it looks better than a spreadsheet. And with Salesforce Lightning, it looks a lot better than most other databases as well. Now, databases are becoming prettier with more UX UI design, but it still is looking fairly nice. A big pro for Salesforce is going to be the different automation tools that you can use for sales, marketing, and service. Now let's talk about an example of a renewal opportunity. So let's say you have a contract every year with multiple clients that need to be renewed every year on a scheduled basis. Now, typically you might put this in your calendar, or you might put this in your brain somewhere, or you might put this into a spreadsheet. But with Salesforce, you can create an automation to, once one deal closes for this year, create a new opportunity for next year and transfer over any of the information that you wanted to about the last deal onto the next deal, as well as create different reminders to reach out to this client as the renewal date gets closer and closer to being ready to sign. So this is really awesome. So then you don't lose people if you forget about it. You don't lose people if your rep leaves the company. And it helps us to not duplicate our work when we have a lot of information. Maybe you just take last year's contract and you change a few numbers, and then you have the next year's contract. This helps us so that we're not duplicating all that work and we can save a lot of time and a lot of money. Another automation that I kind of briefly just touched on is that you can create a contract based upon information that you put within Salesforce. Let's say that you sell based upon a number of people in the company. You can input that number into Salesforce and create a formula within Salesforce to plop out how much is going to cost the customer. And so then you don't have to do any of that math. And you can take that number, or maybe you want to fudge it a little bit, you can do that as well, create a discount for them. And you want to plop that right into the contract, as well as any contact information into the contract. You're able to do that within Salesforce. You don't have to move the different fields from an old contract. You don't have to create a new contract every time you want to sell something. You can automatically create that contract within Salesforce using the data that you've already put in the various fields within your Salesforce opportunity. As well as you can automate sending that contract to your customer. If it hits a certain stage in the pipeline, you can make sure that you have one contract already filled out, but then also you can tell Salesforce to send that out to the customer so then they can sign it and send it back as soon as possible. So if used right, Salesforce can save you a lot of time and a lot of money, as well as make you a lot of money. All the time that is used that can be saved using automations can then help your sales reps to sell to more potential customers and bring in more revenue and more profits. Salesforce can also process payments, but this is an extra add-on that you'll have to talk to Salesforce about when wanting to use it. But this can save you a lot of time and a lot of money in the long run. So is Salesforce worth the price? You're gonna have to do that for yourself. See if it makes sense for your company and your situation for as many users as you want to use the platform, as well as if you are willing and able to pay for someone to come in and create all these automations, or have someone on your team learn how to create all these automations, which will take time. So that is my little spiel. A little bonus that I do have for you today is that you can negotiate with Salesforce based upon an amount of users that you might want to have on the platform. If you have a lot of users that you're going to have, then they will knock down the price per user oftentimes, just because you have so many people on the Salesforce platform. And the best time to talk to Salesforce about a contract, in my opinion, is going to be January, because their fiscal year ends in January and they want to meet their quotas, so they are willing to give out better deals at that time of the year, which I've used at a few companies to negotiate their price down per month. So that is my little spiel on why you'd want to use Salesforce, or why your company would want to use Salesforce. Of course, there are other products out there on the market that are able to do similar things. First things that come to mind are HubSpot, but that is for usually a smaller company. So maybe you want to start out on HubSpot and then move to Salesforce, which is pretty common. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you have any questions, be sure to leave them down below and I'll try to get back to you as soon as possible. If you are a Salesforce admin, or you are someone who wants to learn more about Salesforce, check out my courses down below in the description box. If you want to join the family, subscribe, like, you can join the email list at salesforceemily.com. And thank you so much for joining me. I'll catch you guys in the next one.